What's up, gentlemen? So tonight you've got a super hot date with that spicy senorita. Well done. But before you have that date and do what you're gonna do, gentlemen, today with a little help from my spicy senoritas at Salon Posta, I'm gonna help you know exactly what to do before you hook up.
Shower. I mean, like, you feel like that one's obvious, but I guess it's not. Shower.
Before you hook up with someone, definitely clean your balls.
So these girls had me rolling when they were talking about clean your ass, clean your ass. I'm like, really? It's a problem? Well, here's the deal. Apparently it is. Guys, instead of just grabbing a bar of soap and like washing not only like the junk, but also like your booty, right? You gotta make sure you're actually removing all the funk that is built up. And so it's critical that you use an exfoliating puff or body scrubbing something in order to really remove all the dead skin, the scaly, crusty, nasty, funky, stinky stuff that actually builds up. And so if you're currently just using a bar of soap or squirting body wash in your hand, that ain't getting it done, son. But this, a scrubbing loofah or body puff, whatever you're gonna call it, definitely does, all right? And so if you wanna check this out, guys, I'll link to it down below if you want to grab one. I'm also going to link to some body washes. If you're looking for a body wash that smells incredible and isn't going to dry your skin out, guys, the Pete and Pedro body washes are insane. I'll link to those down below. Go check them out and read the reviews. They are incredible. And like I said, we also sell the scrubbing exfoliating tools to keep your balls squeaky clean and to wash your stink. Woo! Tickles a little to wash your stinky ass.
Babe, wash your shit.
What specifically?
The balls. The balls. Wash them good.
And after you have scrubbed all the filth, all the funk, all the nastiness off your body, gentlemen, now it's time to make sure it doesn't smell bad a little bit later, all right? The first thing I want you to do is apply your deodorant, all right? My favorite deodorant is the Recipe for Men. Get that on. After that, ladies, what's next?
Powder your balls.
Powder your balls.
And powder. Powder.
Fact, if you are not currently powdering your balls stink. It's an inevitable fact. That is what balls do. They stink. Unless, of course, you are using a high-quality, non-talc-based powder like the Pete and Pedro powder. When I decided to create a powder, guys, I knew that I had to bring it, like, super strong because I was competing against, up until this point, the best product on the market, which was Chassis. But I was like, you know what? There are problems. I don't like the way that Chassis dries me. I feel like it's too drying to some degree. I also hate the price. It's expensive. Pete and Pedro powder works better than Chassis and is less expensive. Chassis gives you 4 ounces. Pete and Pedro gives you 5. And the smell is incredible. It's so fresh, I literally wish I could smell my own balls, gentlemen. This stuff is incredible. But we also have a fragrance-free version as well. 99% of powders on the market use talc as the main ingredient. Now, talc, unfortunately, is pretty bad for your body and the boys, which is why it's critical. If you are gonna be using anything to keep dry, you gotta make sure it is talc-free. Instead of talc, we used baking soda. We also used cornstarch, along with a lot of other incredible botanical and natural ingredients. Bottom line, if you like Chassis, you are going to love the Pete and Pedro powder, and I'm gonna link to it down below along with a limited time discount code. Now you're like, yo, Alpha, what about the cool water trick? Can yours do that? These glasses of water represent your sweaty balls. On one side, you've got talc-based powders, the other Pete and Pedro. When you add talc-based powder to your sweaty balls, mix it up. What you are left with is a pasty, chalky mess in your pants. When you add your Pete and Pedro powder to your sweaty balls, mix it up, what you're left with is powder. Nothing but powder. The choice is yours, gentlemen. A white, talky, milky mess in your pants or Pete and Pedro powder. Guys, hit the link down below and go check out the newest addition to your soon-to-be smelling fresh ball arsenal, and that is the Pete and Pedro powder. Not only does it work better than anything on the market, it smells amazing and it's gonna keep you fresh and dry. Not only Big Al and the twins, but also your booty, because this is perfect for eliminating swamp ass. A little sprinkle in your hand, little whoop up the booty, gentlemen. You are good to go. Gentlemen, hit the link, use the code to make your balls smell better.
Make sure your nuts are smooth and your balls are powdered.
No, I have nothing to say.
Sheets. You gotta change your sheets. You know, as dudes, we're great at a lot of things. Changing our sheets, not one of those things. But if you expect somebody to enjoy and have a pleasurable experience rolling around in them, they better be clean. Because if they're nasty, if they're funky, if they're discolored, they're crusty. Ew! The other thing you gotta do, gentlemen, after the sheets, make your bed, right? Because the truth is, it's gonna set the mood, the ambiance. When somebody comes over and your bed is a disheveled mess, it's like, ah, this guy doesn't really take care of himself. Is he gonna take care of me? Take care of me.
Brush your teeth.
Ooh, yeah. I like it.
Yeah, because stinky breath in your face is disgusting. Brush your teeth.
Brush your teeth and don't forget the back of your tongue.
Don't have boogers in your nose. Check yourself, check your face.
You actually look at people's noses?
Well, what if they're like coming to give you a kiss and there's a booger hanging out of their nose and then they have like dragon breath? That's gross.
Nose hair, gentlemen. I didn't even think about this, but Courtney brings up an incredible point. Guys, if you are actually everybody, every single one of you needs an incredible nose hair grooming tool. Guys, this one at Pete and Pedro is the best. Not only does it work better than anything I've ever used, it comes with a bunch of other attachments. And the other really cool thing, guys, it's USB chargeable. You literally never need a battery. I'm telling you guys, I am a huge nose hair trimming snob, right? With nostrils like this, I have literally tried like everything. And so when I decided to actually create a nose hair grooming tool, guys, I knew it had to be the best. This is the best nose hair tool you'll ever use. And those other attachments are also amazing for doing little like detail work around your mustache or even like cleaning up the hairs on your ear, your nose, wherever. Gentlemen, bottom line is I'm gonna link to this along with everything that I mentioned down below. And don't forget to use that discount code. Next up is toilet, baby. How clean is your toilet, all right? Before somebody comes over to your house, you gotta make sure that it is sparkling clean because it's really funky and disgusting. If somebody comes over, goes to go to the bathroom, and it's like splattered or there's pee running down or it's just nasty, gentlemen, this is a bad situation and scene. And so before anybody ever comes over, make sure that the toilet is clean, make sure that the paper is refilled, and make sure...
Wipes, gentlemen, each and every one of you should be rocking some wet wipes in your bathroom for not only your guests, but also you. Remember, it's all about booty smelling amazing, right? And if you're just using like toilet paper, you're a freaking savage.
This tip I would like to give you guys is something that you gotta think about, whether or not somebody's coming over to your place or you're going out and you may potentially have the opportunity to get frisky a little bit later on, and that is protection. You've gotta make sure that you have thought through the protection process. But I'm on the pill, gentlemen. Don't believe the hype and don't trust it. It's all about you rapping that rascal. And so a good rule of thumb is have some condoms at your place. If you're going out and you're like, yo, where do I put them? In your sock is actually an Alpha M pro tip that I'd like to give you from back in the day when I was on the prowl for spicy senoritas. Keep 1, 2, possibly 3 condoms in your sock. You're good to go. Gentlemen, you are amazing. If you dug this video, drop me and the spicy senoritas at Salon Posta one of those for being like, yo, mama, are my balls and my butt really that bad?
We notice these things.